In this example, we'll graph the cosecant function using the reciprocal identity cosecant theta equals 1 divided by sine theta. So if we want to graph y equals cosecant theta, we can determine sine function values, then take the reciprocals of those, and that'll give us cosecant function values. So if you're familiar with the graph of y equals sine theta, as we see here graphed in light blue, we'll take specific sine function values and then determine the reciprocals of those to determine points on the graph of y equals secant theta. So for example, where sine theta is equal to 1, the reciprocal of 1 would still be 1, so cosecant theta would be equal to 1. So where sine theta is 1, cosecant theta is also equal to 1. So this point here and this point here are points on the graph of y equals cosecant theta. Here, where sine theta is equal to negative 1, the reciprocal of negative 1 is still negative 1. Now let's consider where sine theta is equal to 0. Well, 1 divided by 0 is undefined, and therefore cosecant theta does not exist when sine theta is equal to 0. And that's actually where cosecant theta would have vertical asymptotes. So let's sketch the vertical asymptotes for cosecant theta when sine theta is 0. There'd be one here, one here, and one here. Now we just need to determine function values between the vertical asymptotes, and we'll have a nice graph of y equals cosecant theta. So somewhere over here to the right of 0, sine theta is equal to 1/2, and the reciprocal of 1/2 is 2. So where sine theta is equal to 1/2, cosecant theta would be equal to 2. So there's a point on the graph of y equals cosecant theta. And the same thing over here on the right, where sine theta is equal to 1/2, cosecant theta is equal to 2. And as sine theta approaches 0, somewhere in here, sine theta would be equal to 1/4. The reciprocal of 1/4 is 4. So where sine theta is equal to 1/4, cosecant theta is equal to 4. And there's also a point over here where sine theta is equal to 1/4. And very quickly, we have a nice piece of the graph of y equals cosecant theta. And we could do this between each vertical asymptote. Let's go ahead and do the same over here where sine theta is negative. Where sine theta is equal to negative 1/2, somewhere in here, the reciprocal of negative 1/2 is negative 2, so cosecant theta is equal to negative 2, where sine theta is equal to negative 1/2. Where sine theta is equal to negative 1/4, cosecant theta is equal to negative 4. And the same thing is true over here on the right, where sine theta is negative 1/2, cosecant theta is negative 2, and where sine theta is negative 1/4, cosecant theta is negative 4. And that's pretty much all the information we need to make a nice graph of y equals cosecant theta using this reciprocal identity. And we could do the same for this interval here, but it's going to look something like this, and like this going off the screen. So I think this is a nice method. If you can remember this identity, you can use it to make a nice sketch of y equals cosecant theta.